This time, there's mud, rain, more mud, and sunshine. Moto America's Super Sport Class races a barber. We have the highlights. GNCC has a tough mudder in West Virginia with a surprise winner. AMA Pro Flat Track gets rained out, but we still talk to the winner of three in a row. And is Chad Reed done? We have the update in news. All that and more only on the Racer X Show. Hey, what's up? Thanks for checking out the Racer X Show. I'm Greg, your host for this racing highlights and news show. We'll give you all that stuff you just saw, plus how to win a 450 motocrosser, and we'll update you on World Superbike, including how American PJ Jacobson did in World Super Sport. It might make you smile. All that and more coming at you right now.
The Racer X Show with Greg White is being presented by Acherby's Soul and Passion, and by Yoshimura, the leader in performance exhausts.
Let's start the show with the motocross segment presented by Acherby's. Interesting news, where after five straight weeks of racing, the Lucas Oil Pro Motocross Championship finally had an off weekend. They'll resume this weekend at the Geico Motorcycle Buds Creek National in Maryland. That's on Saturday. Now, unfortunately, missing from the lineup will be former champion Chad Reed, who underwent season-ending shoulder surgery last week. The veteran Reed has struggled throughout the summer to this point, and he failed to score points at the last round at Mount Morris, PA. Unfortunately, those races appear to have not only been his last of the season, but possibly the last for his Discount Tires 2-2 Motorsports team. According to numerous sources, several key members of the staff were laid off last week, including Mike Goose Gosler, among the most respected mechanics in all of motorcycling. Goose confirmed his dismissal on a phone call with me yesterday. But is this the end of Chad Reed, who has been a fixture of the AMA circuit since 2002 and has more career AMA Supercross podiums than anyone in history? We're not able to reach Reed for comment right now, but we're hearing that he hopes to sign with another factory-supported team for 2016. Chad is one of the most popular and well-known racers in the sport today. Here's hoping he comes back healthy and faster than ever, and who knows, without the day-to-day worries of running his own race team, maybe 2-2 himself can make another run at what would be his third Monster Energy AMA Supercross Championship. Like I said, Pro Motocross returns to action at Buds Creek in Maryland. Moto One is live on MAV TV beginning at 1 p.m. East. That runs for 2 hours. Then a bit later on in the day at 9 p.m., the second moto is on NBC Sportsnet or NBCSN. Warm up the DVR. You want a new 450? Make sure you've entered for this chance of a lifetime. You can win a brand new 2015 450 motocross bike of your choice from Honda, Husqvarna, Kawasaki, KTM, Suzuki, or Yamaha. And all the proceeds go towards funding the Asterix Mobile Medical Center. How? Head to wina450.com and purchase as many raffle tickets as you'd like before August 21st. And sit back and wait for the winner to be chosen on August 22nd at the 2015 Bud Light Ironman National in Crawfordsville, Indiana. It's as easy as that. The winner doesn't even need to be present to claim their prize. You'll be contacted shortly after the announcement to choose the preferred brand that you want. What are you waiting for? Get tickets now at winna450.com and help support the Asterix Mobile Medical Center today. Now our road race segment presented by Yoshimura and a look at round five of the Moto America Series from Barber Motorsports Park in Birmingham, Alabama, and the hotly contested Super Sport class, where the racing is always tight, and so is the championship. A quick look at Sunday's race one results have J.D. Veach victorious over Josh Herron and Bobby Fong, the Yamalube Yes Graves Yamaha rider winning by a slim quarter of a second. As for race two, here's CBS Sports commentator Jonathan Green with the highlights.
Joint championship leader Josh Herron would start from the pole, but it was Bobby Fong who took the whole shot. Good start also from J.D. Veach, chasing his teammate Garen Gerloff, who started third. Bobby Fong then, now his shoulders healed up. The Triumph van definitely going to be a factor here at Barber. On board with J.D. Veach, chasing Garen Gerloff. It's been Herron, Gerloff and J.D. Veach all season long. Whoa! J.D. Veach out of the seat! How did he save that? He's still on board somehow on the number 95 and still in fourth place. But Bobby Fong leads Herron and Garrett Gerloff on board with JD. Herron cuts it tighter, trying to find a different line. Gerloff trying to find a way through. Whoa! And Gerloff gets his nose cut off by the leader, Bobby Fong. And there's nothing between these four. And that little incident allows JD Beach up to second place now. And here comes JD. Beach then hits the front for the first time. Heron's not done. Goes wide at Charlotte's Web. It's all going on here. JD Beach looking for victory. They started the day neck and neck on 140 points, but it's going to be JD Beach.
Same top four as race one, with the margin of victory twice as big at a half a second. As it sits, JD Beach is holding onto a slim 10-point margin, but there's still a lot of racing to go in the Moto America Super Sport Championship. This weekend, the Moto America Series moves to Tooele, Utah for round six of their championship. You can catch live streaming coverage on MotorTrendOnDemand.com and FansChoice.tv. That's happening all weekend long. In the nearly all-British affair known as the Indy World Superbike Championship, Kawasaki's Tom Sykes led all 21 laps of race one, winning it over his teammate Johnny Ray and Aruba.IT Ducati's Chaz Davis. Race two is a different story as Ray beat Italian Davide Gugliano by a slim 1.29 seconds. Sykes dropped back to fifth, further extending the dominating points lead that Ray has in this one. The top four in points, all from the island of Great Britain. Shifting the focus to World Supersport, American P.J. Jacobson finished a strong second behind winner Jules Cluzel. Points leader Keenan Cefalu was able to remount after a last lap crash to finish 11th. 20 separates the top bunch. Next stop for the Superbikes, Laguna Seca in mid-July. PJ is back in action in Malaysia in August. MotoGP races up Aston Holland this weekend. That's a Thursday through Saturday affair, so coverage is on Fox Sports 1 Saturday morning at 7:30 a.m. East. Check that out. And that is our road race segment presented by Yoshimura. AMA Pro Flat Track was supposed to return to race action over the weekend in Maryland, but a dumping of rain halted race action. The bummer gave rise to something good for us. Please welcome to the Racer X show the rider with the hot throttle hand, winner of the last three races, number 42, Crosley Radio's Brian Smith. Hey, Brian, thanks for joining us. How you doing, man?
Thanks for having me. I'm good.
All right, let's jump into it. After four rounds, you're currently fifth in points. Disaster start in Daytona, but since you've won both AMA races and a gold medal at the X Games in Austin, tell us, man, what's been going on?
Yeah, Daytona started out really rough. It's on the 450 DTX bikes, you know, the motocross bikes lower down, and I've never really been a fan of them. It's a motocross bike, you're trying to flat track, and I'm an old school guy, so more of a flat tracker, I guess you'd say. And I haven't got a handle on the DTX bikes, the motocross bikes lower down, so I struggled down there. I've done good there before, got a third, been on the podium, but this year was the worst ever. I think I got like a 15th in a last place, so basically come out of there like 1 point. You know, I had my work cut out for me, no doubt, so went to Springfield Mile, one of my favorite tracks, and put the hammer down. Luckily got the win, and went the next weekend to Sacramento and got another win, so that catapulted me up there in the points, and the next game's gold medal with the third win. Unfortunately, that wasn't AMA points. It was AMA rules, but no points, but still, to get a gold medal was really awesome there.
A lot of people associate flat track with Harley Davidson, but you and your team have been doing something different, Kawasaki. It seems to be a good bike for you. Is that accurate?
First, yeah, it's a great motorcycle. I think it's made my career continue to be better and, you know, basically just continue my career. I was kind of at a standstill on the Harley deal, and Ricky Howerton and the guys in Indianapolis brought a little IndyCar technology to flat track with the Kawasaki, and it's just fit my riding style. I think it's improved not only my career, but the whole career of flat track in general, because now that half the paddocks Kawasaki's, you know, so I'm as proud of the wins that I've got on the Kawasaki and for Kawasaki. I'm more pumped that it showed guys there's another alternative to flat track besides the Harley Davidson.
Looking forward to this championship, looking at the tracks that we have ahead of us, how are things looking for you and your chances?
You know, I was looking real good at Hagerstown this last weekend. I was bummed that got rained out, but there's a lot of good tracks left for me. There's a couple of tracks that might not be that great for me, but I'm pretty confident. I mean, yeah, it'd be nice to be leading the points right now, but I'm pretty confident that towards the end of the season, we got, you know, I think three more mile tracks left. Pretty confident I'll be the guy to beat at them races, barring any problems. You know, we got Lima, Ohio this weekend coming up, one of my favorite tracks. I've won that before. You know, anywhere on a twin, I feel like I'm a threat to win. I feel really comfortable with my team and my bike. So it's just been fun these last few weeks, riding, having fun, and being fast. It's something that don't happen very often. So as much as it's cool, I'm enjoying it too.
Well, Brian, thanks for joining us, and good luck this weekend.
Thanks a lot, Greg. Thanks for having me. And in case you wondered, you'll probably never see one. This is what a gold medal looks like.
You can check out Brian Smith and the rest of the field as they race it up live with the AMA Pro Flat Track Series. Head on over to fanschoice.tv. It'll tell you when and how to check it out. We're going to start our AMSOIL GNCC presented by Maxxis coverage of Round 9 from Snowshoe, West Virginia with the XC1 Pro ATV class, where the race was exciting, unpredictable, the points chase tightened up, and we had a first-time overall winner. Well, it was a muddy one for this one, not as bad as Sunday, but it made life difficult for some in certain sections, including the infamous Howard's Hole, legendary for swallowing up a couple of dozers a few years back. That spot on the course would define the race. Early on, it was JMRATVRider.com Jared McClure who would control the lead in the early portions of the race, before, on lap 3, points leader CSTPirateMX.com's Adam McGill would take the spot and hold it until the final lap. As the white flag flew, Fast Track Wolf Racing's back Brian Wolf had worked his way into the lead on adjusted time. He started 10 seconds back on row number 2, but was on time the race leader, even with McGill and NFAB AmPro Yamaha's Walker Fowler out front in the physical lead. And then, with just 1 mile to go, McGill would find himself stuck in the thick, deep mud of the infamous Howard's Hole. McClure bombed on by to retake P1. Fowler would challenge him on the final corners, but McClure was able to hold on and come away with his first ever GNCC Racing overall win. Brian Wolf would claim his best finish of the season with third place overall. McGill would unstuck himself for ninth, but congratulations to Jared McClure.
I think, like I say, clip a tree, rolled it, but got going pretty quick, and you know, started pouring that last lap. Walker got around us, started bombing through some stuff, and you know, that's when the chaos happened, and we hit the mud hole down here, and I just came out ahead of everybody.
And this is how things are going for McGill. Fowler grabbed back a handful of points, but still holds the lead until round 10. That's September 19th. The summer break is on. Okay, now to the GNCC bikes, where one day later it was a totally different story. After about 13 hours of rain fell overnight, Saturday was a huge mud fest, so much so that it was hard to see who was on what bike. But in the end, solid and steady with a good end of race strategy won the day. XC1 Pro points leader Factory FMF KTM's Caleb Russell began on the first row of the unique live engine start, replicating the start of GNCC's birthplace, the Blackwater 100. After taking the early lead, Russell would start to feel the pressure from Rocky Mountain ATV MCs and West Virginia's very own Thad Duval. Duval made his bid for the win on lap 3 and continued to lead. That was until Russell, who paced himself in the mud, took back the lead on lap 7 of 10. When lap 8 was over, Russell would lead by 18 seconds. But it was on the penultimate lap, that's when the reigning champ put the hammer down and broke free of Duval. His lead, 1 minute 24 seconds. He'd hold that until he saw the checkered flag waving to take his 8th win of the year. Bummer for Air Group Rockstar Energy Husqvarna's Ryan Sipes, he'd DNF due to a knee injury during the race. But a mudcake Caleb Russell was a happy Russell. Safe to say that in this graphic, Russell is crushing everyone this year. We'll just leave it at that. And by the way, if you have a television, you can catch GNCC on NBCSN for a half hour of fun from Tomahawk, Sunday at 3:30 p.m. East. And you can always catch archived racing anytime right here on racertv.com. Get out and watch some racing. Pro Motocross is back at it. This time we stop at Budge Creek in Maryland. Moto America is in the Salt Lake City area, Miller Motorsports Park, perhaps the last pro race there, so don't miss it. MotoGP is in the Netherlands at the Assen Circuit. Sunday's a holiday, so racing is Saturday. AMA Pro Flat Track stops in Lima, Ohio. Try and get a race off. Lima is fun, 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 folks. Go to that. And ATV MX is in Millville, Minnesota for round 6 of that one. High-flying, bar-banging action on ATVs. If you're in Minnesota or near the area, go check it out.
The RacerX Show with Greg White is being presented by Acherby's Soul and Passion and by Yoshimura, the leader in performance exhausts.
All right, that's going to do it for us on the Racer X Show this time. Special thanks to Brian Smith for joining us and to Thunder Multimedia for providing us with those 6 slow motion clips and those solo shots of Brian Smith. Thanks, Thunder. Really appreciate you. And of course, with what's going on with Trad Reed, this thing is staying in the box. It's going to be a collector's edition someday. Well, that's it. It's all the time we have. We're out of here. For the fine crew at the Racer X Show and Racer TV, I'm Greg. Remember, we are all racing all the time. Hands off Matutu Motorsports, man. Come on, Reedy. Maybe I could get you to sign this thing.